Hey everybody, how you doing? Welcome back to Tiny Lines Big World. Today I'm doing my recap of our second day in Barcelona, our second full day. So today was a day with a lot of ups and downs. Lots of downs. So let's start from the beginning. So we got up this morning. Eli ended up waking up first and he was really good. He went out to the living room of the place and played a little bit and kind of kept it down. We all kind of rolled out of bed, the rest of us at around 9 or 9:30. It was a really, really rough night's sleep last night. Kim was up in the middle of the night with Emma. Emma was up from about 2 o'clock in the morning to about 5 o'clock in the morning, somewhere in the middle there. I got woken up. I was up from probably 3:30 to maybe 5:30. And then eventually, Emma magically appeared in our bed at some point, and she cried out a number of times in the night. Eli cried out a number of times in the night. Oh my gosh, it was crazy. So yeah, let's just say that when we got started this morning, we weren't at our best. So we walked out. We walked down to the local Mercat, and we got ourselves a couple of espressos, which immediately changed our moods. Then we decided we were gonna take the metro and go over to La Rambla and the Gothic Quarter and, you know, hit up the Boqueria and whatever. We did that. Got on the metro, got all the way over to the Gothic Quarter, wandered around a bit. Gothic Quarter's incredible. You know, the medieval thing just doesn't get old with me. I can't get over my fascination with medieval-style cities and the narrow streets and the tall buildings and, you know, like, you can't wear your sunglasses because there's no sun, you know, because it doesn't reach down on the bottom of the alley except for one time a day. But I just, I'm mystified by all of that and I love it. The problem I have is tourists. And we're one of them, or four of them. That's always a conflict that I have in my head, is how do we be tourists and not be terrible, horrible, awful, obnoxious tourists that we see everywhere. While it was beautiful, and we found some beautiful spots, we found this crazy Roman columns that were just tucked away inside in some little side street with some side little courtyard, and wound our way in and just boom, inside the courtyard, Roman columns. Crazy. That was the good. Downside is lots and lots and lots and lots of tourist shops. You know, a lot of tacky souvenir garbage. The other thing was lots of urine and poo smell all over the place. Yeah, that was kind of disappointing. It's kind of hard to appreciate how beautiful it is when it stinks like pee, to be honest. But you do the best we could. We went out to La Rambla. We walked La Rambla for a little bit, but it was so crazy. There's way too many people. We really figured out that we like to stay in like two neighborhoods over from the tourist neighborhood and just have sort of the city to ourselves, or at least have that feeling. So we walked down La Rambla. We found the Boqueria. We went through the Boqueria. The Boqueria was amazing, but crazy crowded. And, you know, we had some of the fruit juices from different stalls. Now, here's an interesting observation. Some of those juices were really delicious and amazing and like fresh fruit just squeezed into a juice in a cup and here you go. Some of them had tons of sugar added. We actually got one for each of us at the end, and it was just like solid sugar to the point where it just didn't taste good anymore. It was too sugary. So that was kind of a disappointment, but mild disappointment. We want to eat at Kim's at the Boqueria, but there seem to be people waiting. So we've decided that we're going to head back on a different day first thing in the morning and see if we can get there first thing in the morning. That's the one place I would like to eat. So we did the Boqueria thing. It was cool. I had some jamon. It was jamon. It was delicious. Pardon my horrible pronunciation. And then, let's see, we had been recommended to go to this comic book shop that some friends of ours had suggested. And so we headed there. It's called Arkham Comics. And it was cool. It was great. We took pictures and we walked around a little bit. It's a tiny little store. And then we just kind of wandered. We were heading in the direction of some of the Gaudí buildings. We ended up at Casa Batlló, but before we got there, we just kind of wandered through the Gothic Quarter and out onto the main drag. And this is an incredibly walkable city, I'll say that. I've been to other places that weren't nearly as easily accessible to the person who just wants to walk. It's only maybe a 40-minute walk from where we're staying to the Boqueria, and I can envision that being a really fun, awesome, easy walk. So we went to the comic shop, and that was cool. And then we went to Placa de Vicens, I believe is what it's called. I'll put a link down below. Thank you, Atlas Obscura, for introducing me to the Barcelona baby drop-off. It's this unmarked thing on a building, and it's really fascinating, and you should totally go to Atlas Obscura and look it up, or look at the link down below. So we saw that, and ended up wandering over to Casa Batlló, which was magnificent. You know, the Gaudi stuff, it's so strikingly different from everything around it, and I'm no architect or scholar of architectural history or anything, but it's so dramatically different from all the buildings around it. It was absolutely magnificent. So we stood there for a minute. Now, this whole time, we had multiple meltdowns from the children. Little girl was being extremely demanding today. I want this. I'm thirsty. I want this. When are we doing this? When is this going to be over? When are we going to be there? What's the end of this? What are we doing? Where are we going? Why are we going? What are we doing? Blah, 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 blah. She was basically being four. But it was like four on steroids. She just was crazy. A little man was like breaking down at the drop of a hat into tears, or snipping at us and you know, being snarky with us. Yeah, we had a really rough morning. Traveling isn't perfect. It's very easy to present on the internet the face of a happy family and everything's cool and man, we're jet setting all over the world and aren't we cool? Look at us, way! But you know, the reality is the trip costs money. You know, we're gonna have to pay for this trip for a few months after this. It was not easy for us to get here. It was not easy for us to do this, but we're doing it anyway. And I think that's the real takeaway, is that in spite of all that, it's still worth doing. Still worth doing. At least I hope so. I'll let you know in a couple of days after this. But after Casa Batlló, we signaled the end of the day. It was the middle of the afternoon. We're like, all right, that's it. We need to go back. So we came back to the Airbnb. I took a nap. I was out for probably 3 or 4 hours. I desperately needed it. So what happened during our nap? Anything exciting?
No.
Nope. Okay, everybody stayed inside and did stuff. Played with cars. You know, maybe the kids needed an inside day for a change. But yeah, we couldn't go out. And then the original plan was, well, let's feed Emma and Eli a little something and then maybe go out again. But she was nodding off at the table. So we ended up putting her to sleep. And we've been Airbnb bound the rest of the day. So, as a tourist, I'm kind of disappointed. As a dad, hey, you know, it's just kind of the way it goes. I'm kind of over it now. I was upset earlier. Probably said some things I could have said better. Probably had some parenting moments that I'll regret in 20 years. I'm hoping that the good stuff overrides my shortcomings as a father. But I'm doing my best, and at least we're trying. You know, I want to talk to you about the good and the bad, because it's not all good. But it's not all bad either, you know? It's just part and parcel of taking the trip. That was a short recap of today. Not a whole lot that we got accomplished, but we're gonna start over again in the morning. We have tickets for Sagrada Familia first thing in the morning, so we're gonna get up and head out. And, you know, you'll see me again tomorrow with another update of what happened during the day. So thanks a lot for joining us. Please like the video. Please subscribe to the channel. Please stay tuned. There's going to be lots more content coming to you from our Barcelona trip. And we have more surprises in store as we head to Paris. And on to Carcassonne, France. And on to Sitges. So stay with us for our adventures. And we'll see you soon.